was too expensive. So they were always being compressed. No, you've got to write it on the sets we already have built. You know, but it's just a bar set. No, we can't afford to build a bar set this week. You got to have, what, talk in the living room again? Yes, they have to have a conversation again. So there was always this kind of frustration that any television writer has. Because really, they have the sets they have. You have to go around, look at the sets that are built, and construct your story around what is already there. And then, so you take this writer who's been frustrated for years with Buffy ideas, and you tell her, you can have any. And she comes up with, you know, Captain Kirk, you know, Captain Spike. And when I read it, I was like, wow, just because you can doesn't mean you should. and it was, you know, because I'm sure for her, it's like, why not? And so that, looking at that is one of the reasons that I wrote Into the Light. And I specifically kind of wanted to write a comic book under the constraints, the same constraints as if it was being filmed on the set. So I tried to write something that would fall within the budget of a Buffy episode and get the character back on the streets, back as an underdog, away from special effects, because Spike never really had a lot of special effects. There wasn't a lot of epic stuff. The epic stuff was for angels. Spike was always kind of more hanging out with the rats and the cardboard and stuff. And I tried to get him back to his roots.
Instead of spaceships and bugs.
What's that?
Instead of spaceships and bugs.
Instead of the bugs and spaceships.
Hi, James.
Hello.
So, taking the challenge of asking you uncomfortable questions, can you tell all of us what's one of your deepest, darkest secrets?
One of my deepest, darkest secrets? Well, then it's not a secret.
One more question. I heard you're from Modesto, right?
That is one of those things.
Is there anything you like to do there when you come visit, like any spots you have to go to?
Growing up in Modesto, I was a teenager and I wanted to be an actor, and I knew that Modesto was not for me. And I fought in my escape room at about age 13. And I wore like zoot suits, Chinese exercise, like a big afro. And I was like a walking billboard. I'm not really from here. I wanted to be the freak that everyone's like, where did he come from? And then after my son was born, his mother and I divorced and she moved back to Modesto. So I found myself every other week spending the weekend, a long weekend in Modesto. And I rented a little farmhouse. And I spent 6 days out of the month in Modesto. And I kinda, as an adult, I was like, wow, this is actually kind of pastoral. Not so bad. Like the trees had gotten bigger in the time that I've been gone. And now that I didn't have to escape it was actually kind of pleasant. And now I have a little soft spot in my heart for Modesto. What I like to do there, there's a great racetrack where you can race cars at about 25, 35 miles an hour.
Unless Carol is up there, yeah.
Where is that stuff? Briggsmore.
Okay.
It's one of those places where, you know, there's got arcades and all these games and there's the ball and all that. But they also have a track that is awesome. To the point where, like, I was taking my son.